Rise and awaken. Varric asked me to bring you here. Using your mind, my magic, and a drifter's body, you are now the custodian to this telekinetic vessel. How do you feel? Yes, this body is undead. Find Varric. He will explain why I've done this. Go through the sewers to the warehouse. He's waiting for you there. However, I must warn you. This body's flesh and skills are weak. It's best you build them up as soon as possible. Increase your strength, perhaps some charisma or maybe some vitality. It's entirely up to you. But choose wisely, for the dangers in this dark city will test your capabilities quickly. Yes, one more thing. Beware of the Wraith. Neither you nor I own this body you possess. It belongs to the dead, and they will come for it eventually. Do not attempt to fight the Wraith. It cannot be destroyed, ever. The best you can do is run or hide, and hope it returns to the darkness. Take this. Don't leave. Come here. Find Varric if you have any questions. He's in the warehouse. You can get to it through.
In there, fledgling, hunter. Miko did good, very good. Your flesh looks great. Though not sure why I'm so surprised, since she worked wonders with me as well. How do you feel? That's normal. You will feel better after you build up the vessel's skills and attributes a bit. Destroying a vampire emperor and an entire sect has made some of the other bloodlines a bit nervous. In about 10 days, you're going to be greeted with over 9,000 undead at your doorstep. Judging by past events, I might normally have faith in your ability to deal with the situation. But it would appear the undead have stepped up their game a bit. The factions in this city, under the authorization of the Council, are working on a new synthetic blood. The project is headed by the Taka Corporation under the codename Nemesis. Neural embryonic morphine immortal synthetic immune something or other. I don't fully understand it, but I do know it makes the kindred even more powerful, much stronger, with increased senses and the ability to morph into any organic creature. It's not, and when I heard of this, I thought it might be in your best interest to pay a visit to see for yourself, possibly delay or even destroy production of this new blood before the enhanced undead appear at your gates. It wouldn't have worked. With the new blood drug coursing through the undead's black veins, they can sense any hunter cells nearby. The only solution was to place you into a telekinetic vessel. This is where Miko's talents come in. You should be safe from suspicion now, allowing you to move freely among the sect using only your mind and Miko's magic. Oh, and you will undoubtedly notice that insatiable feeling of thirst for blood. I'm afraid that the authenticity was a necessity, so of course this vessel is a blood feeder. Taka Corp rented some space in Chinatown, in a back room of a local herbal store. The space is probably being used for a lab of some sort. It's not their main lab, but it's still something worth checking out. Chinatown. You can get to it through the large doors at the north end of this warehouse. But not so fast, since getting inside the lab section will most likely be tricky. Giggler. Not exactly. In fact, he's just plain crazy. but unfortunately someone you're going to have to meet. Giggler's the leader of the Bogata clan, and for whatever reason, Takacorp is using him as their main guinea pig and test subject in their new blood trials, giving him access to some of their restricted areas. Takacorp's security is a bit more advanced than that. Giggler probably enters the lab like other Taka employees, using a retina eye scanner. So I will leave it to your imagination on how you're going to make that happen. He's in the Bogata hideout. It's a warehouse converted from an old deep dungeon uncovered under the city years ago. The entrance is behind a large metal garage at the end of the first alley in Chinatown. Not likely. In fact, finding him probably won't be easy. His office is deep and possibly hidden. Better brush up on your intimidate skill, and then find a guard to interrogate and set up a meeting with Giggler. It's probably the only way you will ever find him. How are you coming along? Have you found Giggler?
What do you need? You don't have enough money for that. You don't have enough money for that.
Over here. What's up? Hey, haven't I seen you around before? Wait, your face. Yes, I do know you. But I thought you were dead. Yeah, maybe. You looking for some action, or just your next victim? There's a poker game going on inside. Nah, I won't play with those guys. Those crooks cheated a solid gold ring right off my finger. I had the perfect low straight flush. Ace to the five, all the way. But no, they said dark Chinatown rules, with aces only counting in high straights. Those guys are thieves. Yeah, it was. That ring had sentimental value. It was the first ring I ever stole. Vicarious, Yeah, it's an amulet, but it's really mostly just a legend. It's supposed to allow the wearer enter interlocked secret passages, leading to the Guardians of the Eye. If the Guardians are destroyed, their essence will charge the amulet, and the amulet, when charged, can prevent the regeneration of health to powerful vampires. Of course, no one knows what the amulet is, or if it actually exists.
That cannot help you currently. You must feed.
Better brush up on your intimidate skill, then find a god to interrogate and set up a meeting with Giggler.
I wasn't taking anything. Wait, who are you? You're not Bugatta. What are you doing sneaking up on people like that? You scared me. Oh, good. But keep it down, huh? If the Bugatta catch me in here scavenging through their stuff, I'm burnt dust. You might want to get out of here too, since you don't look like you belong here either. The Bugatta clan are using this dungeon as a warehouse to store ingredients for some sort of secret synthetic blood they're developing. This place is crawling with guards and they can smell intruders easily. Especially with that new crazy black nectar they're drinking. It's supposed to be better than the real thing. I don't know, since I've never touched the fake stuff. I prefer my blood warm and dirty. I'm just in here because some of the bioproducts from the process are worth some major dinero. Not to mention the amount of weapons they have in this place could probably guard against the raid of the council itself, if necessary. This entire dungeon is a huge burial chamber where thousands of weapons were buried with the fallen warriors from centuries past. Some are even supposedly enchanted with magic. I don't think the Bugatta give a crap about any of that, though. They're just using this dungeon as a place to hide blood. Oh yeah, one more thing. Watch out for the pits around here. If you get too close, you'll fall down into the next level. No warning or anything. Of course, that's where the good loot is. But it can be hard to find a way out once you go deeper than floor one. And there's also some pretty strong creatures down there, too.
That cannot help you currently. You must feed